Okay, well, I'm super excited to do this. I have been dying to get Celeste on a Zoom because obviously she's a rock star. If you see her in the Diamond Boss Babe page. So I would love for you just to, I guess, start off just talking about why you joined NetWorks and how, your journey of going diamond.
Okay, so I joined last March, and my lore had followed me on Instagram a week before, and I watched her post for exactly a week, and then I reached out to her, and I was like, "Hey, this is like weird that I'm texting you, but how are you making so much money from your phone?" I just saw she was a college student just like me, and I was working three jobs and taking 18 credits a semester, and still just scraping by to pay bills, and I didn't have a lot of money for groceries and all of that, so that's why I reached out to her and got started right on the spot. I didn't even like think about the $99. I was just like, whatever, like if she can do this, I can do this too. And when I joined, I got a lot of customers right in the beginning, but I kept telling myself that it was so hard to get distributors that I wasn't getting distributors. So I kind of was just like half into business, half like not working for about 5 months. And then Nicole Manzoli, she's a triple diamond. She reached out to me and was like, "Your PBV is like 1,000. Like, why don't you have distributors?" I'm like, "It's so hard. I can't do it." And she kind of punched me in the head and was like, "No, like you're making it hard." And as soon as I like realized that like I could do this and I watched The Secret on Netflix, I enrolled a DT like the next week. And then, so that was August, I believe. And then I went executive in August, Ruby in September and November, Emerald 2 months after that. And then I promoted to Diamond the month after conference last year.
That's awesome. So now you've just been, maintaining, and obviously your goal, I'm sure, is to a double diamond. So
Yes, hopefully this month I'm close.
yes, yeah. Something that I feel like, they always talk about taking it to a whole nother level. That's like the slogan. But was there something that you feel like you changed in your business because, like to start really like mass enrolling LCs and DTs, like what did you change in your work ethic or in your business every day?
So a couple months ago, I went from just being like a steps to success girl. Like I would always complete them every month, but I never got more than like five or six LCs. And I didn't change what I was doing. I just did more of it. So as soon as I started 10 timesing my efforts, I started enrolling 30 plus LCs a month and 10 plus DTs a month.
That's crazy. That's insane. So basically, you were just messaging more people and following more people and following up more. So just doubling, tripling your efforts. That's awesome. What does your work day look like? Do you work right now still? Are you in school?
I'm in school, but when I went diamond, I quit all of my jobs. And this is actually my last semester in college, and I only needed four classes. So I was going to school in Fort Lauderdale, but my boyfriend was living up in Orlando. So I moved in with him when I went diamond, and I've just been taking my classes online. So all I do is it works, and then those few classes online. But if you still work and like go to school and all that, you can definitely still do as much as I do. So I wake up and I usually wake up to at least like 20 DMs. So I answer all of those, send out more, and I do five messages on each Instagram. I have three Instagrams every half hour, so 10 an hour. And in between like messaging, I'm following up. I don't just follow up on Fridays. I follow up every day because I have too many people to follow up with to just do it on Fridays. And then my boyfriend actually follows for me.
That's
But
nice. Wish mine did that.
before he like knew how to do that and stuff, I would just between messaging spend half the time following up and then the other half following. I post at least 3 times a day. I'll try to do it like morning, noon, night. But sometimes I won't get my first post out until like 1 in the afternoon, and then I'll post later. And I do a life post, a product post, and a not at work picture every day.
Yeah.
Do you Unless I like really want a DT one day, then I'll like do 3 life posts.
Okay. So what does your following up look like? Obviously I'm sure you're a huge advocate of getting people's numbers, right?
I will not talk to people on Instagram.
I totally agree. So when you follow up with people, what's like a message that you typically send that seals the deal?
So the one I'm using right now for PLCs, it's, hey, I'm super excited because I have just one open spot for greens and I want it to be yours. My phone is going crazy with orders because of the holidays. Let's get yours in quick. And then for PDTs, I'm sending, hey, I keep thinking about how amazing you'd be at this business. I'm training one more person to get this new diamond $10,000 bonus, heart eye emoji, and I want it to be you, heart emoji. What do you say?
That's good. Yeah, that's really good. Because I feel like when I follow up for DTs, I'm just like so blah. I'm like, hey, girl, I'll do so long, make extra money.
I have a big thing in my notes of just follow-ups I can send you. But
yeah.
I've gone through like all of them by now, but I usually pick one and then I'll like add or take away something.
Yeah, that'd be awesome because then I could just copy and paste them to the girls. I know a lot of – it's nice to change up what you used to. I realize that. And then especially for new people, you're like, what in the heck do I write? You know?
For my first follow-up with someone, I usually just say, well, depending on where the conversation left off, I usually just say, did you have any other questions about what I do? Or did you have any other questions about the greens or whatever they're interested in?
Okay. Yeah, that's a really good idea. So I know you said you have 3 Instagrams and some people have more than one, other people just use one. Did you make 3 because you felt like it would prevent you from getting blocked or?
No, so I only have 3 because my first one is maxed out. So you can have unlimited amount of people following you, but you can only follow like 7,500 people.
Oh.
And that was maxed out. And then my second one was getting close to maxed out. And I didn't want to like just have like no backup. So then I made a 3rd. It is a lot of work running all of them. So I don't recommend to my team to make another Instagram until they get maxed out unless they don't work and this is their only job and they have the time to run both of them. But it's 3 times the work of what you're normally doing.
Yeah. Yeah. Ashley just said she has 3. Yeah. And I think Bailey, if she's on here, has 3. And then Laura has 2. I'm like so like scared to do more than one. So I'm like waiting. So I'm like, oh, I'm such a squirrel. I get so distracted. I feel like, well, I know I'm going to have to eventually. Okay. So do you have any, I guess apps that make your business easier?
Do you use it? My boyfriend like kind of uses Captivate, kind of like not.
What is that? I've heard of that before.
It like follows for you, but to do it like the best way to benefit your business, you still have to go through and like click on the profiles that you want. It just helps to not get blocked because you can like click to follow like 500 people, but then it will just do like 200 an hour.
That's right.
How many? Oh, 40 an hour, not 200. Sorry. It does have a setting where you can just like click execute actions and it follows like 40 random people, But I don't like doing that because I don't know if it's following fake accounts or like other AdWords people or like creepy old guys and stuff like that. And even though I check the profiles when people request to follow me, it's just like easier or more, I think more efficient to just look at the profiles before.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm like, I think I want to try it, but I don't know. I only message, do you message guys and girls or do you just message girls?
I message guys on Facebook. I only do it on Instagram if I run out of like girls to message.
Mm-hmm.
It usually doesn't happen a lot, but and then I use just like picture editing apps. I use PicTap Go, Facetune, Fonto is to put a picture over a picture. WordSwag. Yeah, Fonto. I can send you this red one.
Okay, so that's like how you guys do the layered pictures.
Yeah, it's like so you pick your initial picture. I can't. Oh, there we go. And then you click the three things at the side.
Mm-hmm.
And click add image, and then you pick the other picture, and then you can make it bigger, smaller, or alpha. You can like fade it away.
Oh, that's cool.
And move it around and stuff.
That's awesome.
And then I use WordSwag to put like the text on things. And then the new one is Hype Type. It's like the video ones. It's the purple one. I think it's like $3.
Yeah, it's awesome. I love that one.
I tried using, oh, what is it? I think I deleted it. There's an app called like Scheduler where I have my girls that have trouble with time management, and you can like make your schedule and then it like reminds you to do it, and you can just put it in your reminders, but it gives you like as many different categories as you want, and then say you like you need to post like three times, you can add it, and then once you post once you just double click like that category and then it like fills up some of the percentage. So just, and then I use the followers app to message all my new followers and unfollow people that don't follow me and who unfollow me back. So in this app, you can only unfollow 60 people an hour, which works fine for me because I have nothing else to do, so I can unfollow every hour. But if you can't, the cleaner app, this one, unfollows like 200 people an hour. But the followers app, it tells you who all of your new followers are. So that's how I message. I just scroll down to everyone that started following me 4 days ago and just message all of them. So I don't have to write them down or like take screenshots or anything like that. And the app lets me go like back and forth between the app and Instagram.
That's awesome. Yeah, one of my other sugars told me about that. I need to download that. That's probably so, so helpful. You know, because Instagram changes so much, so you never know, like, at the top, if they've been following you forever, you know, it always changes. Going back to, you know, how you mass enroll so many LCs, I know everybody kind of has, like, a certain message that they follow. Do you have like a certain first message and like the option message that you use, or do you kind of like create it as you go?
Yeah, I only message for LCs and I always use the same message. And it's, hey Amanda, I know this is random, but I was looking at your page and was wondering if you'd like to try one of our products and give me your opinion on it. smiley face. I think you're so pretty and would love our products, heart emoji. You'd get a huge discount for doing so. Would you be interested? And then if they open it and don't respond, at the end of the day, I go through everyone. And if I was sending, did I scare you? But then one of my girls started sending, did I catch you at a bad time? And I think I like that better.
Yeah, I've been using, I'm so sorry if this message freaked you out or something. And I'm like, oh my gosh, no, it didn't. But that's a really good, that sounds like more professional. Did I catch you at a bad time?
And yeah. Then for the people, right after they answer, they usually just ask what the products are. So I say, health and wellness products, what's your number? I'll send you more info. It's easier than DM, smiley face.
Awesome. And then when you're texting them, do you just go into like someone who wants to grow out their hair, someone who wants to?
So I have a script. I think it's pretty much the same as Jade Hooper's, that video of like her.
So the LC video, like the beginner video, you tagged me in. Okay.
So I message them and say, hey, it's Celeste on Instagram. And then I say, so first tell me some things you might be interested in. We can go from there. I still need someone for wraps to firm, tone and contour, greens for detoxing your body, HSN supplement for hair and nail growth, ThermoFit to help speed up your metabolism and burn calories, Confianza for stress management, protein shake or a cleanse to rebalance and reboot, which sounds like a product you prefer. And then from there, they usually pick a product or they'll say, well, I want to lose 10 pounds. So if they give me a goal, then I'll ask for their budget. But if they just tell me what product that they want, I just describe the product. And then they usually say, wow, sounds great. And I say, they're amazing. You would love them. I'd love to give you my last personal discounted spot. And that's I got from Nay. And then I say, oh, awesome. What's the discount? And say, greens retail for $55, but you can get them for $33 when you do a 90-day challenge, which sounds good to you. And then some people will just say 90-day challenge, and then some people will ask what it is. And if they ask what it is, I say, so the program is pretty awesome. You get products each month for 3 months. You don't pay upfront, just month to month, and you can change your products around each month. For doing this, you get 40% off and points on each order, which you can apply towards a product at the end, which you can get something for almost totally free.
That's a great way to explain that.
But if they don't ask what the 90-day challenge is, I don't explain it to them unless they want me to put their order through for them, but I never like ask to get their info unless they're like doing something wrong. I always walk them through it. But when I walk them through it, I give them my link and say, go here. And then I give them the instructions. And then I say, click, check out, and then click the top join now button to get 40% off the 90-day challenge. So I'm saying the 90-day challenge twice. And then when they order, they have to agree to everything. So,
yeah. Yeah, and we'll all get those people who, like, you know, they literally sign to the terms and they still are like, why are you sending me all these products? And you've, you know, but.
I've been getting a lot of people that they'll be ordering and then they're like, oh, this is an every month thing. Or they'll say, can I stop at any time? And I'm like, yeah, after 3 months. And they're like, oh, okay, cool. I think because I say yes after 3 months, instead of saying you have to complete the 3 months, like that yes beforehand, like, doesn't freak them out as much.
Yeah, I'm going to try that. Yeah, that's something I think that so many distributors have questions about. You know, because I think everybody's afraid to tell people they have to buy something for 3 months. But I always think back to, I don't know if you know, but I was a customer of Nayara's. And it's always so funny because I still have the text messages saved. And she followed up with me like 6 times to buy. And I kept like ignoring her. And then finally I was like, oh, okay, fine. And yeah, so, and I was one of those people that, she like explained it to me like over text, but I didn't even see it that I had to buy 3 months. So then when it charged my card the second month, I was like, oh my gosh, why didn't it charge my card? But you know, I was really happy after I lost so much weight. So like, you know, you never know who you're getting, but, okay. So one more thing that, and don't forget you guys to ask questions in the chat too. I know that someone asked if you could put all this in the chat. What I will probably do, just because I know she's on, you're on your computer, right?
Yeah.
So that would be hard for her to type it up. So I might just have Celeste like copy and paste the stuff that you guys want and send it to me over Facebook Messenger, and then I can put it up on our like little team page for everybody to copy paste if that sounds good. That way you don't have to sit and like type everything out. Let's see here. So a lot of people, you know, they need distributors, and that's a struggle. Like you said, you're kind of scared at first. So do you message for DTs, or do you live post and then maybe message whoever likes it? What's your thing?
I used to message for distributors, but I felt like I was getting a lot of people that just joined because they thought it'd be like fun or cool, but they didn't like need the money. So they didn't like work hard and ended up like quitting. So now I don't message for distributors. I just get all of mine from people that reach out to me from life posts, and then just following up with people that I've been following up with since like I first started when I was messaging for distributors. I've been getting a lot of texts from the posts that say like text opportunity instead of saying comment emoji or just text me. And I'm really bad. I don't message my likers anymore because I was just getting so many people that were just like, oh, I just liked your picture. Like, I don't care about like what your caption was.
That happens a lot. Yeah.
Like I do get a lot of LC interaction when I do like 90-day challenge posts, especially like hair, skin, and nails one. I'll get like a lot of like comments or people like DMing my picture, but I get the most texts from my life posts.
Okay. Yeah. That's what I hear a lot of people say, you know, is if it's like I get a lot of comments off the now hiring posts.
Yeah.
But like you said, most of them are people that, they just want, they don't know what they're signing up for really. So, so when you get somebody like texting you about becoming a distributor, can you go over like briefly the conversation you have with them?
Yeah. So, I text them and just say, hey, it's Celeste from Instagram. And then I ask how they are. And then they usually say, how are you back? And I say, I'm great, thanks. So basically what I do is I market for It Works. I just show others how amazing the products are and make commission off the products sold on my personal website. You can get bonuses too. And we don't even keep stock of products. Customers order from your personal link and the products get shipped directly to them. So it makes it really easy. Literally all I do is post on social media and talk to people. You do the same and our whole team would be here to help and guide you. And then from there, they usually say, awesome, how do I get started? And I say, it's so fun and super simple. To get started, you need to get the Business Builder Kit. Inside that kit is a box of wraps, in parentheses, $100 value, a ton of marketing material, and some samples of defining gel. That kit is $99 and they've created a website for you too. And then from there, they're either like, oh, I don't have the money, or I get paid this day, or they'll sign up. I have like a list of excuses that Emily sent. I think she sent in a diamonds chat. Let me see if I can find it. They're like excuses when people say like, I don't have time, or I don't have the money to start, or any of that. So if you don't have that, I can send that to, but
you can tag me in if you find it too. And then I can just,
People will literally give you every excuse under the sun. And I just shoot all of them down before they tell you why they're actually not joining. And usually it's because they're scared. First they'll say they don't have money. And then I'll be like, no one joins because they have money. They join because they need money. I totally understand. I had to borrow money from my boyfriend to join. And then they're like, oh, I don't have anyone I could borrow money from. I'm like, okay, get creative. You could open a credit card, sell old things, like babysit, whatever, whatever. And then they're like, oh, well, I don't think I have the time. And then I say, the great thing about this is you work on your own time right from your phone. When I started, I was taking 18 credits a semester and working 3 part-time jobs. So I definitely know how it feels to be super busy. But you can do this and be busy. The busiest people are always the most successful. And then they'll say, oh, well, no one will buy from me. And I say, the only way no one would buy from you is if you're not trying. And then they'll finally just be like, I'm just super nervous. So it's really just like shooting down excuses. I get like probably like a fourth of my distributors sign up on the spot. But most of them are after like 8 follow-ups.
I'm really glad you said that too, because I think when you first join, it's like you're scared to be annoying. And that's something that you eventually have to learn, is like not to care. And, you know, how many times do you usually follow up with LCs, would you say?
I get most of my LCs to sign up right on the spot. But usually after like only 2 or 3, I get some people after like 10. But it's usually on the spot or after 2 or 3 follow-ups. But I always use the example Sarah Nierman gave about following up. So you're not like being annoying or whatever. You're doing them a favor. They're interested in products and they may have forgot about it. So you following up, you're doing them a favor and reminding them about what they're interested in. So Sarah Nierman, she made a video a couple months ago saying that she was supposed to buy eyeliner from a unique representative, and she told the representative, like, I just bought eyeliner. When I run out, I'll definitely order some from you. A couple months go by, she ran out of eyeliner, and that unique distributor never followed up with her, so she forgot she was supposed to buy from her and just went to Sephora, bought some new eyeliner, and then a few days later saw one of the distributors like post and was like, oh crap, I was supposed to buy from her.
That's so true, yeah. Yeah. I need to find that. It's probably such a good video. So do you guys have any questions so far? I know a lot of you on here are ruby and above right now, and you're trying to go emerald or diamond this month. So do you do any sort of self-development? I know some people are into it, some people aren't.
Yes, I'm a huge believer in self-development. I'm trying to stress it so much on my team. It literally, like, changed my world. Like, I used to be, like, not, like, the negative, like, not a very negative person, but now I just try to see, like, the positive side and everything. And it just helps you grow so much. And I think that's why I started 10 times in my effort. I listened to You're a Badass at Making Money. And if you've never had Audible before, you can download Audible and you get a month free trial. And then they also give you a free credit. So you can listen to You're a Badass at Making Money for free. So there's no excuse to not listen to it.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm loving Audibles. Like, I love reading, but I'm loving, like, I think Nye was the one that told me to listen to Be Obsessed or Be Average, the Audible book. And it's really nice. Like, you know, some people are like, well, I don't have time to read. So it's nice to plug in something in your car or while you're taking a shower or getting ready in the morning. So that's awesome. I didn't know that was free.
I always listen to self-development when I'm like doing the dishes or while I'm in the shower. What's the other book? The 10 Times Rule by Grant Cardone is awesome. I haven't finished it yet.
That's the guy that wrote, Grant Cardone is the one that wrote Be Obsessed or Be Average.
Oh, yeah.
He is great. He is so good. Are you listening to it or are you reading it?
I'm listening to it.
I'll have to do that 10 Times Rule. 10 times.
It was on YouTube, the full audiobook, but they just took it down. So hopefully it'll be back up soon.
Okay. Well, this has been like so helpful. You are the bomb.com. I'll make sure I get any messages that you guys like really want in particular. I know a lot of you are gonna want like probably the LC and potential DT script, and then I'll try to find that excuse list. That sounds awesome. But yeah, thanks so much. Do you have anything else that you want to add, any encouragement or anything?
If you're trying to promote this month, you just literally like 10 times your efforts. If you're only messaging like 30 people a day, like message 300 a day, especially if you have more than one Instagram, you should definitely be messaging at least 100 new people on each Instagram a day. And I just stick to the script, and that's how I get so many loyals to sign up right on the spot. So I'll definitely send that to you.
Yeah. Thank you so much. This has been really, really helpful. And you guys can follow Celeste on Facebook and message her if you're like, oh, dang, I forgot to ask her this. So, but thanks so much for letting me interview you.
You're welcome. If you're going to follow me on Instagram, just shoot me a DM and say that you're on Gabby's team so my boyfriend doesn't block you.
Yes, for sure. Well, thanks so much, and I'll get you guys those scripts.